Yay! Here's the new Chorrada, number 3. And this one is titled Outlaws. And this one is dated May and June 2014. And copies are available by sending the usual, a zine, a donation, a letter, a mixtape, you know the drill, to Chris and Lola, Calvo Sotelo, 13B, 4B, Plasencia, 10600, Cáceres, Spain. This is his attempt to start making zines again after a couple of years of inactivity. I will put his coordinates below. You know, it's nice to slip some euros in an envelope, or if you can write a Spanish check, you know, I suppose that's nice, but it's not specifically necessary for a lot of zinesters. And this is about this guy, first of all, that he would see from time to time, not very often. A guy who turns out to be 57, from the USA, and he was living in caves, and he'd gotten sick, I forget with what, he'd gotten hurt somehow. Oh, he had a bad skin cancer, and was not healing up well, and it did not look good, and some doctor there butchered him, but Chris, who does this, Chris Mininger, saw him later and he was doing much better. He had healed up pretty much and was looking pretty chipper. And I believe he lives on 150 euros a month. Boy, after renting a troglodyte house in the south of France for a week in Provence in May of this year, I don't know how I'd feel about living in a cave. You know, when he saw the guy one time, he was like, "Hey Richard, how are things?" "Well, all my stuff is damp and water has been dripping on my head every morning this week as I cook my breakfast, so I guess I've been better, you know." And, oh, by the way, chorrada means like a little nothing, a knick-knack. All right. You know, the guy has to do some strategic stuff and not really tell people exactly where he is. And he's had to move along because hikers came up and they were a risk, you know. I mean, you're vulnerable then. I mean, how are you going to leave your stuff and everything, though? They might rip it off, they might stay there a while and attract attention, you know, you don't want that. Alright. And this has a lot of history and lore of the region, and Chris debunks a lot of the local legends about places and Spanish history. It's very well written. He's really doing very well with the quality of his writing, which was always fine, but now he's kind of gone to a higher level. Let's see. Bravos of the West is about the USA. You might like this. It was originally published in 1962 as The Deaths of the Bravos, and it's by John Myers Myers. Apparently that's his name, John Myers Myers. All right, brushing off the dust from the countryside. See, he puts a little bit of Spanish in here. Oh, yeah. This is a funny story about how he and his wife and a couple of friends were indicated a cool, cheap place to stay for only 30 euros a night for a double room. And it was just like, it was hell, you know. It was absolute hell. So, you know, just because it's cheap or just because it's expensive doesn't mean it's good. I mean, I stayed in a 4-star hotel in Paris for a full week in 2010, and there was a strike going on, and you couldn't even get into your room. You know, the door lock system wasn't working. It was horrendous. You know, the employees were like robbing the guests and stuff. It was pretty awful. I was okay, but also that hotel, I couldn't believe it was 4 stars. I mean, it looked kind of run down to me, really. And I'm not picky. I was fine. I had a great week. Business and pleasure, really good. So this is an account of their stay in a place, and a comic book store, and a bar, and a lunch, looking around the city where they were visiting, a photo exhibition, more food, something called the Oriental Museum. And this has to do with Spanish missionaries in Japan and other parts in Asia. There are other zines and some contacts listed here. Pretty much zines and zine references listed in the correspondence section. I usually get mentioned in this. I've been in touch with this guy since, I don't know when, a long, long time, I suppose the early 90s or something. I think he's 39 or so, has a Spanish wife. I think he's from the East Coast of the USA, and he's been in Spain for well over a decade. He works there, usually hard physical labor, and I forget what his wife does. And they love to travel. They think nothing of taking a couple of months off. And yeah, see, there's a little mention of me. Lisa B. Falour. Yeah, I sent him a nice postcard with a beautiful stamp from the Museum of Modern Art in Lille and mentioned how much I liked the second issue, how good I thought it was, how sincere my praise was, and that I had a clip up of it on YouTube. And I also have a clip up of the first issue. So there are other zines listed here. Loserdom zine, that's a cute name. Ugal. Okay, that's from Ireland. And here's a picture of Chris. It says, Chorrada is a Spanish word meaning knick-knack. And there are some phrases here in Spanish you can look at. We'll give her some little thing is one way you could use the word chorrada. The film is nonsense. Talking about a movie, you know, it's just, you know, bogus. Stop talking drivel, no digas choradas, to have a piss, that's funny. So I really recommend this, and again, I will put the address in the low bar, and, you know, it's just 3 sheets of paper, you know, it just fits in an ordinary envelope. Really. It might be just 2 sheets with a third sheet separate or something. It's not a big deal, really. But the print is rather small, and it's very neat and black and white, and I think it's really good. I hope you have a look at it and consider it if you like zines or if you're interested in expat stuff and you're interested in Spain and cross-cultural marriages and Americans abroad, I suppose. Okay, bye.